What if they made Zen flavored coffee?
You have like the Keurig pot, but instead you put like you mash like 5 Zins in there. Hey everybody, my name is Chris Warren.
My name is Matt Lopes.
Welcome to the You Should Be Worried podcast.
I just found out how people are supposed to spell the word Baccalaureate, and fuck you. That's have you fucking seen it? Do you know how people spell that word?
I don't know how to spell
it. It's Baccalaure. No,
there's an H in there.
No, there's no H.
But there's an H in Bachelor.
No, yes. See, that's what I'm fucking saying. I was taking a shit in Ben's bathroom downstairs, and there's a book that said it's like the bedside Bachelorette, I guess, and it's in there. But the way they spell it, it's Baccala. It's because it's not Bachelorette. It's Baccalaureate. No, but that's the same word. No,
Matt was just reading a completely different word.
That's Bachelorette. That's the word Bachelorette. Don't say sure. Don't say sure to me like that. Is that not Bachelorette? Baccalaureate is its own word?
It sounds like we're talking about Star Wars characters, dude.
Is Baccalaureate its own word?
That's like Jabba the Hutt's minion.
Ooh, now Chris is doing it. Baccalaureate, that's like Jabba the Hutt's minion. That's
okay. I've been told that that you guys don't give me enough credit for my wordplay on the podcast. I've had multiple messages of people being like, I watch the podcast and they don't give you enough credit for all the...
You're making that up.
No, I'm not. Why would I make that up?
Because I take part in
Yes, but you're not on camera, well. So you smile. And yes, you also participate and you do it. But whenever...
So you guys is not fucking... You guys is not accurate then.
You need to smile more. It's like it's like telling a woman she needs to smile. You have to smile more on the podcast. Mm-hmm. You have to like it.
Baccalaureate is a college bachelor's degree.
That's what I'm saying. Baccalaureate, right? Baccalaureate.
That's actually someone
fucking nuts,
that's
dude.
That's a professional baccarat player. Baccalaureate.
You're all right. Don't be better than me.
I'm fucking crushing it, dude.
But Bachelorette, I always assumed was how you spell it, like on the TV show. Like the Bachelorette.
I think that is how it's spelled. You're talking about it.
You're saying there's two different. There are two different words.
Yes.
So baccalaureate is not what I got at college. That's not what I got at college at all. What is a baccalaureate then?
I just told you.
What is it?
A college bachelor's degree.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I have.
Yeah, but bachelorette is a fucking girl who hasn't been married yet.
But when I went to college, I got my bachelorette. I didn't get my baccalaureate.
You did not get your bachelorette.
They should honestly take it away now. If I can't even pronounce the
degree, dude, I'm sending this to Southern Connecticut, and they're going to revoke your degree, dude.
A bachelor's.
Okay.
Bachelor's.
I got my bachelor's. Yeah. And that's Baccalaure.
Yes.
Okay.
Bachelorette is just a party they have for a girl who fucking isn't married yet.
All right. And one more time, what does baccalaureate mean?
That's just another way to say bachelor.
That says bachelorette. There's a T at the end of that shit.
I'm gonna punch
there's a
you.
T at the end of it. It's not bachelor's. You. If there's a fucking T in that word, that's a bachelorette.
All right, stop. I can't.
No, don't stop. I need to get to the bottom of this.
We've explained it like 5 times.
You've not explained it 5 times. You haven't explained it once.
Okay, let me try.
I go to college. I earn my bachelor's degree, right? Yes. But in college, what's a bachelorette then?
So,
or a baccalaureate? It's not. Is it the same thing as bachelor's?
Yeah, it's a different way of saying a bachelor's degree is a baccalaureate.
Okay.
And a bachelorette.
But I wouldn't say that I got my bachelorette at college.
No.
It's just combining words.
All right. I'm sorry. All right. I think I understand.
Okay. I'm glad we started off.
I think I understand
strong.
Now. I'm so sorry. Holy fuck.
I'm trying to think of another example.
No, we just let's. Please just move.
No, it's
fine. Have you ever seen the movie Magic Mike?
Yeah.
Maybe. I think so.
Yeah, those were a lot of bachelorette parties. But
I know what a bachelorette
party is.
But
those strippers
is.
Did not have baccalaureates. Yes. That's why they were strippers.
That's why they're strippers.
Yeah, because they're dumb.
Right.
They're dumb and sexy.
Right. Holy fuck. 2 weeks ago, I lost a comedy competition, and to drown my sorrows.
Let's give a round of applause for that.
To drown my sorrows, I ate a dozen Krispy Kreme donuts in one sitting. 12. A dozen is 12. I washed it down with 2 milks on my drive back from the casino.
Oh, you didn't eat them there with people gawking at you?
I would never eat it there.
You should have eaten it there, and people would have, like, some kid would have pulled their mom's coat and be like, "Mommy, mommy, look at the freak."
If Morgan-san had a circus, had a circus part of the casino, I'm pretty sure I would have been recruited.
Next time Cirque du Soleil is doing Mohican, they're gonna pick up Matt, dude.
If I'm considered a freak for indulging in what I love,
I mean, that 12 is insane though.
12 is nuts. I knew what I was doing. Wrong. But I was like, well, what do I?
Were they plain or were they different flavors?
I was like, I want more than eight. More than eight? Which is crazy to think in your head.
So I want
to. I'm like, all right, I could order just eight, right? I could just order eight donuts. I was like, no, a dozen sounds.
Oh, so you didn't keep like ordering individual donuts like a bar?
No, with drinks. I was like, you ordered 12. I'm going to Krispy Kreme. This line is long. I'm going to get my money's worth out of waiting in this line. I lost the competition. I lost $250, like gambling. So I'm just gonna spend more money and just fucking drown my sorrows away by eating. And
did you get different flavors or all just regular glaze?
All the same original glaze.
Yeah, you should. It did not get old.
It did not get old. They're so light. The donuts are so light. You know, 12 not that light.
How'd your tummy feel afterwards?
I felt good. I felt like I could have housed probably another four of them.
Dude, you got to be a competitive eater.
No. No.
Joey Chestnut had to retire. You could replace him, dude.
Wait, why did he retire, though? They made him fucking...
So, retired.
He's so good?
No, I buried the lead. He didn't retire. He was banned.
Yeah.
Because he took a endorsement deal from, like, a Beyond Meat company, like, you know, those fake meat companies.
Okay.
And he did, like, commercials for them or whatever, and Nathan's was like, nah, you only eat Nathan's hot dogs. You can't be endorsing other things. And so they banned him from the competition.
Holy fuck.
He definitely That's knew horrible. That was going to happen, though.
But having somebody like Joey Chestnut eating Nathan's hot dogs is good for Nathan's anyway, is it not?
I think it was a win-win for him. I think he probably got...
Because I don't think he gets paid for that. So it's like he made money now.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure Nathan's hot dogs endorses him in some way. But I'm saying, like, he probably doesn't need to keep... he's the only guy who stands a chance at these fucking hot dog eating competitions.
Yeah.
So I'm sure for him to win a fucking 70th one doesn't feel so fulfilling anymore. So
sure.
He probably... cashed out on
but
that.
But he did say he does love doing it.
I'm sure, but like, who knows what kind of money they threw in his face at the Beyond Meat place.
Right.
And he was like, you know what? Nathan will either ride with me or they won't.
Yeah.
And he was just like, fuck it.
Can you imagine only doing those competitions because of the money?
Just for the love of the game.
No,
dude.
Not because you love the game. Like, you fucking hate it. But you're forcing the hot dogs down your throat because you might win some money, and that's what you
do. Yeah,
need.
And you're like a dick.
It's your only skill set is eating hot dogs. You have, like, a third grade education. You just like, I just got to eat them dogs.
Yeah. Yeah, dude.
You guys remember Kobayashi?
No, I don't know what that is. Is that That's kind of beef, right?
That was before Joey Chestnut was this Japanese guy, this skinny Japanese dude that was like the original Joey Chestnut when we were kids. He just dominated the hot dog eating competition.
Was he also doing the thing where he dips like the bread in water and
yeah,
shit?
You got to put him in the water. And just...
That's so crazy. You should have to eat the whole hot dog at once. You shouldn't have to. The separating of the bun and the hot dog should not be allowed. In a hot dog eating,
you
got to
be the judge there.
Because then you're not eating the hot. You're eating fucking hot dog raw and then bread, like just the raw dog, and you're eating just bread on the side. Like it's and if it's gonna be a hot dog eating competition, either eat the full hot dog or get rid of the bread in the competition and just have people eating the fucking meat.
I think it should be like you know how hot dogs come like as a string, like old school style, like they're all in a string in one casing,
like bratwurst.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think you should eat them like that. You should have 1,000. Long one.
And just see who
just
fucking,
suck them down, dude.
Yeah.
No chewing. You just got to keep swallowing chain of hot dogs.
It's like the human centipede of hot dogs.
Yeah, I think that'd be good.
They're all just strung together along.
Oh, dude, I had an odd weekend. So,
okay, go ahead.
What was that reaction?
Package it better. Say it again.
Okay, we'll try again. We'll
all right,
cut.
Go ahead. Go. Right.
I had an odd weekend.
The same way.
I did my show Friday at the Spigot. Shouts out to everyone that came out to that. That was great.
Yeah.
So that was a good show. But then on Saturday, I did a private gig.
Okay.
And so it was at this like house party in Westport. Mm-hmm. And for those that are not from Connecticut, Westport is a very wealthy town.
Okay.
And so it was on this like estate. Like it was, they were really like even for Westport, like they were wealthy.
Yeah.
And I'd been connected through a friend of a friend of a friend. And so they wanted me to do comedy, and I get there, and it's all these, like, exorbitantly wealthy, like, in their 40s, like, late 30s, early 40s rich people. And, dude, I was straight up in Bohemian Grove.
What's that?
You know what Bohemian Grove is? It's, like, back...
Sounds like a part of, like, a town in Beetlejuice or some shit like that.
Basically, back in the day, I don't think it's as relevant anymore, is, like, the rich and famous would go to this thing. It was basically like a music festival almost kind of vibe where they'd go into like this place called Bohemian Grove and do like a bunch of acid and like demon rituals where they would sacrifice things to Moloch, which is this big like owl Whoa. Statue. And it's believed like that's how all the elite, like the conspiracy theory is like all the elite would meet there to do like satanic rituals and like pledge allegiance to each other and like figure out how they're going to control the world.
Oh shit.
And so I was basically at that. It was crazy, dude. Everyone just kept telling me they worked in finance, but wouldn't tell me what that meant.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, oh, she worked in finance. Like, what firm? Is like, oh, you've never heard of it. And it's like, cool. Like, what do you actually do? Oh, I just finance things. And I'm like, all right. And then
these people do not want to be talked to, huh?
No, they were very friendly. They just, when you start asking about the money, they're like, hey.
Hey, chill out.
We hired you to be our token poor person at this. Like, stay in your fucking, don't start asking me about the money.
Yeah, yeah.
Stay in your fucking lane. How's living in Bridgeport? You're poor? Is that fun? What, do you drive a Hyundai? That's gross. Like, they wanted me to describe what a Stop and Shop's like. And they were just like, ugh. That's it. There were Mexicans there? That's disgusting.
So funny.
You know? But at one point, the only person I found that was real, like, you know, that wasn't in this, like, la-la land of being ultra-wealthy, was this one woman that I started talking to, and she was a fellow Jew. So that's how everyone else was, like, a WASP, like, real old-school.
Rich WASP, huh?
Yeah, old-school, like, white money.
Jewish?
I found the one Jew.
Okay.
And so I found her, and... because I asked her if she had a good Shavuot, which was the Jewish holiday last week. And yes. She was like, I don't do that shit anymore. That shit's lame. You do that? And I was like, yeah, it's kind of cool. I like it. I had cheesecake, not a big deal. And but so I start talking to her. I'm like, oh, what do you do? And she's like, oh, I work in real estate. I'm like, okay, finally someone gave me a real answer. I'm like, what do you do? And long story short, she starts explaining how basically what she does is her real estate firm or whatever it's called go into low-income areas, basically get everyone kicked out. Like,
oh,
all
no.
The Section 8 and welfare people, they get them kicked out, and they buy the property for, like, nothing, knock it down, and build expensive condos and, like, Whole Foods.
Oh, my God.
So, like, her firm is literally in charge of gentrifying, like,
Jesus,
you know,
Christ.
The Northeast. And she's like, yeah, it's kind of fucked up, but I make a lot of money. I'm very wealthy.
Dude, remember when you were talking about how you and Mike got fucking hate crimed?
Yeah.
that's the guy. That's the girl that guy was afraid
yeah,
of.
Yeah, no, she was the landlord, dude.
She went to his, like, she went to that guy
yeah.
and caused a problem. So now that's why you guys got hate crimed.
Yeah, because
like the world is so small. Like he actually met her before you.
I literally told her, it's like, you cannot tell the goys about this, dude. This is literally what we get accused of. And she's like, haha, yeah, we do it. And she was the only person that would admit she was wealthy.
Yeah.
Because everyone else was like, oh, you know, I'm not bougie like everyone else here. I'm not really
yeah, right,
wealthy.
Right, right. That's the key to staying wealthy.
Yeah, you just got to pretend you're not rich. And it's just, like, well, yeah. I saw you show up in like a BMW X7 and you're wearing an outfit that is clearly like in the thousands of dollars and you
yeah,
have
yeah.
a Rolex on. So I think you're okay. Right. I think you're, you know. It was great, though, because I think it's because occasionally they interact with billionaires,
mm-hmm.
so they think with their, like, $50 million that
yeah.
they're basically upper middle class. Like,
crazy
they barely getting by. Like, the levels of delusion and detachment from reality. That being said, they were all super nice.
Yeah.
They're all very nice. It was like that episode of The Boondocks. Have you ever seen The Boondocks? Where mm-hmm. it's the first episode where Huey goes to the garden party.
Okay.
That was Ben. Have you seen that?
No.
You guys...
Go ahead, explain it to them.
For those of you who are over 30 like myself, you remember a show called The Boondocks that used to premiere on Adult Swim.
I know of it. I just never watched it.
What I was trying to say is I was basically the token black person there, like that episode. But I was just, instead, I was just the token poor Jewish guy.
The, fuck. I love that they were just so fucking nice.
They were,
you did comedy there? It's like they hired you to be a comedian and they
yeah,
did a set and shit?
Because it was one of the guys' like 40th birthdays. And he likes comedy. And so I was there and I did like 20 minutes like in their grotto. Like they had a, like, you know, the Playboy Mansion has a grotto. Like they had one of those.
Oh shit.
And so there was like a pool in front of me and I was standing in this like artificial cave with like a speaker next to the water. Like that's, we're going to get electrocuted.
Holy fuck.
And I would just do after, they were a very generous audience. Like after everything I said, they were like, ha, 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 like golf clap. Like, ha, ha, ha.
But, all right, but do you think it was the kind of shit where it's like, they were actually finding your shit funny or they were just like,
I think
being rich and doing rich people shit.
I was a dancing monkey.
Yeah.
Okay. I was like the monkey playing the cymbals to the organ grinder. And they were like, oh, look at him. He smells. And there was one really, really drunk dude who ruled, and he jumped in the pool during my set and then was like in the pool in like a floaty. And after every joke, because he was blackout drunk, he'd be like, this guy fucking rules after every joke.
Fuck.
It was such an odd experience, but a lot of fun, dude.
That's so sick.
A lot of fun. And I also,
I love how you always find these fucking really rare places and opportunities to do comedy.
And I just, also, because it was a mansion, right? So I asked to go in to use the bathroom. And they're like,
got lost.
Everyone was like on fucking coke and saying, everyone was like out of their minds by 7 o'clock.
You didn't do any of it with them?
No, it's good. I got offered it a bunch. They were very generous.
Really?
Yeah. People could be
dude,
like,
that's so sick.
You're a comic, you party, want to do coke? And I'm like, I really, no, thank you.
God damn.
Dude, I felt like it was going to be an Eyes Wide Shut party. Like, I felt if I started doing that coke, one of these guys would be like, I want to watch a poor person fuck my wife. Do you want to fuck my wife in front of me? I'm like, all right, man, let's do it. But I was wandering around the mansion. It was really nice. Because I love just rich people stuff. So I was just going, I don't think I was allowed. I was just going through the library, looking at the rare books they had.
I don't think there's anybody in the world who would be like in a mansion and being like, I fucking hate this.
Yeah, it was good. I went into the wife's closet, was just looking through her jewelry. I didn't steal any of it, but it was, she had some nice pieces, you know?
Yeah.
It was great. It was a great time.
Cool as shit.
And then I immediately, so I was supposed to go on at like 7. I didn't end up going on until like 11:30 at night.
Uh-huh.
And then I immediately left because it started getting weird. Like it was going to turn into like a weird orgy. And I'm like, I got to get the fuck out of here, dude. Yeah, these are demon people, dude. These are demons.
Holy shit. I had a gig on Friday in New Jersey. It was another comedy competition thing, but I ended up getting the opportunity to feature for a headliner that I wanted to do more.
Oh yeah, I saw that, man. That was awesome.
That was a fucking great show. So I featured for two shows that night, and so I had to cancel on the New Jersey stuff, and they were very nice about it. They were like, okay, sounds good, no worries. But it was a competition. I really didn't want to do it, dude. Driving all the way to New Jersey to do 4 minutes. It was going to be a four-minute set.
And you know it's always like some weird criteria of what they're looking for. It's not necessarily best set or anything. You know, there's all this weird stuff in it.
Yeah, dude. It was that one. And I don't think I want to do competitions anymore. No. Like, I applied to be in a festival. Like, I didn't sign up for a competition.
Oh, was it one of those where they're like, it's a festival, and then it's like, actually, the festival's a competition?
Yeah.
That's the fucking worst,
like,
dude.
No, dude. I did not just fucking give you guys $20 to $30 in submission fees to then be given a 4-minute set.
Yeah, but if you win, you get like $100 back. So that's
sure. Yeah, if you're one of the fucking
the only person
50 contestants, they made so much money off of us, dude.
So much, and then ticket sales, and then. Yeah. That's what we got to do. That's going to be our side hustle. We got to start running comedy competitions. They'll just be in Ben's backyard.
Yeah. Yes, dude. Ben, you think we can do a surrounded in their backyard?
Yeah.
Fire.
We got to empty the pool and just do it with everyone sitting on the up on
stop.
The
you know that's a pool, you know that's an idea we've had.
I know.
I love that idea so much. Get a fucking huge ass pool or like skate ramp. Thursday night I had to go. What did I do? I did two open mics on Thursday. The open mics went very well.
Nice.
So like I got some new shit I'm starting to throw into my actual set at shows, and it's starting to work pretty well.
Hell
which
yeah,
I
man.
Love. I love it.
Was
so
that
much.
Elbow Room and Spigot?
Elbow Room Spigot. And then I hung out for a while until like, cause I had to pick up my sister from Bradley Airport. So it's like,
how's she doing?
She's great. She's here. She's here from Colorado. She's
did the wife come with
week.
Or?
Yeah.
Nice.
Hell yeah. And it was great. It was a fun time. I stayed late. I went to go pick them up, and then we drove home. And so now they're staying at my parents' house. They got to hang out with my dad yesterday for Father's Day. Shouts out to all the fathers out there who watch the podcast.
Oh, yeah, it was Father's Day. Did you talk to your father?
I didn't talk. Well, I did. but it was the morning and I kind of forgot that it was Father's Day. Mm. He still got a gift from me just via my sister. Like we went.
What'd you get him?
I got him a $25 gift card to Bass Pro Shops.
That's a real dad gift.
It's a real dad gift, of course. You know, like he wouldn't know what to get me. So I'm like, yeah, you could take this, you know? And so I think I was going to say it, and I would have said it to him or at least I would have called him if the first thing he didn't say to me in the morning was, like, I was walking to my car and he goes, "You better wash your car."
I mean, that's solid advice. You
no, it's not solid advice, Chris. The way he said it, it's never solid advice.
You're always taking everything so
it.
Personally, dude.
No, it is personal when it's him. It's fucking personal when it's him. So I ignored him and I drove away and then I didn't speak to him all day. That'll show him. That's the one thing he said to his son on Father's Day.
Isn't Father's Day more about him than you? Why are you making it about you?
It's not. Not about him.
Okay. I mean, it's in the title. It's called Father's Day.
Yeah, you'd think.
Not unappreciative Sunday, dude.
Father's Day does not mean tell your son to wash his car day. It's not the same thing. It's not the same day.
Yeah. I didn't talk to my dad on Father's Day either. No.
But that's you being a bad son. You should really call your
father. My father's a horrible person.
This is fucking hypocritical of me to
I wish my uncle a happy Father's Day because he's the man.
Hell yeah.
Same guy from the Ren Faire rules. Shouts out Jim.
Yeah. Me and you both texted Ben to tell his father.
Which also, we should have John's number at this point. I feel like we should.
We should.
I feel like that should be in our contract. 100%. We have to have John's number. We have to have access to John at all times.
So, yeah, my sister's back. She's from Colorado, and she's not good at Monopoly anymore, dude.
Damn, you crush her?
Dude, to the point where, like, she wanted to go. So, She didn't rent a car while she was out here because she just assumed that she could either take my car or like my dad's car. That's totally fine. I would totally let her do that. I told her. My dad was actually giving her a hard time. He was like, "You can't take Matt's car. He just got that car. You can't." I'm like, "It's in my name. You can take my fucking car because we're
family." But only if you take it to the car wash.
No. And she did. She washed my car. She just didn't do it well enough. She did it all herself. Like, she knew dad was hounding me about it, so she took some, like, water in a hose and, like, watered down my car. Not enough to where my dad actually, it doesn't even matter. So I'm letting her drive my car. My dad's getting mad and upset, and I'm like, if you can put up with dad getting upset, I'm letting you know right now, I don't have a problem you taking my car. Take my car as much as you want this week. And she's like, all right, cool, perfect. But we're at grandma's, we're at my nanny's house on Saturday night. And we went swimming in my grandma's pool, which I gotta say, I haven't swam in so long. It's been like 3 years since I've actually been in a pool. I forgot how to swim. I forgot. I was in there and I was like, I was dipping my head under the water and I didn't know. Like, I forgot how to like plug my nose. I forgot how to like push air out of my nose to make sure water doesn't fucking go up. I was fucking gagging on water in the swimming pool. It was bad. It was not good at all. And I get out of the pool because I'm not having fun in the pool. And
Matt's just drowning at a family function. Yeah.
We're hanging out by the fire. We're drying off. And I'm like, dude, all right, so are we playing Monopoly or what? And she's like, yeah. And the whole rest of the family's like, yeah, we're doing it. And so we start playing. And I'm not doing good at the beginning. Like, everybody else is getting so many fucking, like, properties and shit like that. But then because I'm good at the game and I looked up how, like, the cheats on
you
Google.
You were looking up guides to
like the main points I should follow.
How to rush mid-game Monopoly.
Yes. And so, I ended up doing well. And she was like one of the first people that was kind of getting out. And I was like, okay, well, you said, obviously we all came here in my car. So it's just hang out. You know, if you want to take a nap, you can take a nap. But like, we're here until we finish this game. And
that sounds like
she's like, you're not going to give me your car. I was like, no, I'm not going to give you my car. I'm playing Monopoly, you know? And so she walks home.
How far to walk is it?
It's like 3/4 mile.
Okay, so it's not like right next door.
It's not right next door. It's like 2 streets away.
Oh, that's not crazy.
But it was at 2 a.m. and there's coyotes. And
dude, what if that guy from before tried to kidnap your sister again?
What guy?
You remember the guy?
What are you putting up your phone for?
You don't remember
the guy?
I'm going to show you.
Oh, the monkey? Don't fucking do that shit. That's so funny, dude.
For those that don't
dude,
know,
that is so funny.
For those that don't know, Matt, months ago, like almost a year ago at this point, I was in the car with him. He's like, yeah, I'm just going through a lot. Like, someone kidnapped my sister. And I was like, oh my God, are you? Is everything okay? And he was like, yeah, I'm just, they got a picture of him on CCTV.
Hold on, I'll pull up the photo.
And then he proceeds to show me this fuck. I was like having a heart attack worried about my friend's sister. And then he fucking does this. He shows,
I go, this is the guy.
That fucking photo.
It's a monkey wearing glasses, and he's like, he's a gangster as fuck.
Such a good
I didn't
picture,
get that.
Dude.
I didn't get, dude, that's not, I didn't create that joke. We were at an open mic up at the Nook, like, last year or even the year before. It's an older joke.
Yeah.
And we were talking to Christian, and Christian showed me that phone. And I thought what he was like, look at this photo. But I didn't see it right.
Yeah.
And so I thought he was telling me about like a story, because he was talking about a story, and then some time passed, and he was like, look at this photo. And in my mind, I was like, oh, is that the guy from the story? Like, were you trying to fucking trick me or play me? Was that a joke?
Just unrelated monkey photo.
Yeah. And so I did it to Mike, and Mike loved it so much that me and Mike just start doing it back and forth to each other. Now we always try to get each other. So like, we'll be like, hey man, I'm not feeling too good today. Someone unfortunately ran over my cat. it's really just, we got the guy and everything like that. Like, he's going to prison, but it's just like, I can't hang out. And Mike would be like, oh my God, dude, fucking what? I was like, yeah, this is the guy. And I sent him the photo of the monkey, and Mike's like, oh God damn it. It's so good. Because every couple months, you kind of forget, you know? But if that's all you text now,
yeah.
Like, then it's like, okay, I'm not going to believe anything you
I should have had it locked and loaded, but I didn't think about it. Started with your
it's
sister.
It's definitely
so
one
it was
of those things where it's got to be in the back of your head.
I don't
like,
remember
I'm going to do this to Mike.
You or Mike that got me with this like 2 or 3 months ago. One of you was like, did you see Sydney Sweeney got her nudes leaked? And I was like, really? That's amazing. He's like, yeah, here's the link. And I clicked, and it was just a fucking photo of that monkey, dude. I was so mad.
It's so funny, dude. Sick brothers, thank you guys so much for watching this week's episode of You Should Be Worried. My name is Matt Lopes. You can find me on Instagram and TikTok at Matty Fucko. Please follow and DM me if you have anything that you want to say to my face. And you can look for dates there. Follow In The Making ITM on all social media platforms and YouTube. Always putting out really funny sketches. You can follow Chris Warren at Chris Warren Comedy on all the social media platforms. And leave him a DM, dude. I'd love to talk to you about religion or if you can set them up with any cute girls. Thank you guys so much for watching. Chris, anything else you wanted to add?
No, I got nothing.
Thank you guys so much for watching this week's episode of You Should Be Worried. We'll see you guys next week. Oh, I'm sorry. Also, like and comment and subscribe on the bottom of this video. We appreciate it a lot, and it really
send
helps
it to
us.
Strangers.
Send it to a stranger.
Airdrop it to strangers at the train station or at the local McDonald's.
Absolutely. Yeah. And we'll see you guys next week with our hundreds of new subscribers. Have a good one.